The question was, please review PCI, percutaneous coronary intervention, CPT coding. So these codes went through a change in 2013, and it's a big change. You know, you get used to how something works and you teach it year after year, and it took me a while to really, you know, figure out how to present it in a way, and I hope I've gotten it tonight to help make it clear. So I want to start with some anatomy review. Basically, we're dealing with the coronary vessels and fixes being done to them, whether it's a stent to bridge open the vessel or it's a balloon angioplasty to squish the plaque to the side or an atherectomy to scrape it. We need to know what vessel CPT is recognizing for coding purposes. So these are the major coronary arteries that I have here on the left. So we've got the left main. And by the way, these abbreviations are also HCPCS modifiers. Not all payers recognize them. Sometimes they'll kick them back and say that it's a erroneous modifier when it's not. So be aware that only use them if the payer wants them. Otherwise, you're going to have to resubmit your claim. But for it's really handy for teaching to be able to just use these initials. So LM is the left main coronary artery. LD is the left anterior descending. LC is the left circumflex. RC is the right coronary. And RI is the ramus intermedius. Okay? So those are the five recognized coronary vessels by CPT. Of course, there's more, but these are the ones that coding-wise are recognized. With these PCI codes, they also recognize coronary artery branches. And it's important to know what it branches off of, as I'll show you in a minute why. So the first one, the left main, and the last one, the ramus intermedius, they don't have branches, so you don't have to worry about them. The middle three, the LD, has two branches that are recognized. They're called diagonals. Sometimes you'll see them abbreviated as D1, D2. The left circumflex has two marginals that are recognized. And the right coronary has the posterior descending and the posterior laterals that are recognized. So just to kind of, I'm going to do a little screen split here, see if that works. All right, so I just wanted to show you a picture of some heart anatomy. So here's the left main we were just talking about, and here it is on the picture. And sure enough, there are no branches coming off of it. So that should help you there. The LD is right here. And we can see that coming off the LD, we've got the diagonal. See, and even in this illustration, it's abbreviating at D1 and D2. Then the LC, it's kind of faded in this picture in the background because it's behind where the left main and LAD is. And off of it, you can see the marginals, obtuse marginals. So they're abbreviated OM1, OM2. So those are two are recognized for CPT purposes. The right coronary is over here. And off of it, you can see here's the posterior descending and the posterior laterals. Okay, so these therapeutic procedures can be done in any of these main arteries or their branches. Okay, so keep that in mind now that we have the anatomy down pat. I wanted to talk about, well, what are some of these procedures? An angioplasty, also known as a PTCA for percutaneous transluminal, that's through that tube, coronary angioplasty. It's basically, think of the balloon squishing the plaque. Okay, it's one of the least intensive of all the procedures. Therefore, it tends to be bundled into everything else. So the only time you would code it is if that's all that was done to the vessel. And here's an illustration of it. You can see the catheter with the balloon, deflated balloon, being put in the middle of the vessel, and there's the plaque. And then they inflate the balloon, squishes the plaque to the side of the wall. And here's a little cross-section here. The next higher up in intensity level of procedures is an atherectomy, and that's basically somehow getting the plaque off the lining of the vessel. There's different methods that can be done. They all will use the same code. So you can have a directional atherectomy, or you can have a rotational. It kind of spins and breaks it up into little pieces. or you could have a transluminal extraction. So it's like kind of like a hook. It goes down like a crochet hook and pulls it back. And then you can have laser. Okay, so those are the different kinds of atherectomy procedures. Then we have stents. So a stent looks very similar to the balloon angioplasty, but around that catheter is a like a cage, a synthetic cage, and it is collapsed, and then they expand it, and it helps bridge open the vessel. So now you can have that plaque squished to the side as well as it holding open the vessel. Very similar looking to the PTCA, but that is higher in intensity. Therefore, it normally bundles in the angioplasty. Okay, so now that we have the anatomy and now we understand the procedures, how do we code it? How would we bring it together to code it? So I've got some coding steps here. And again, if you are a Replay Club member, you will get access to all these answer sheets. So sit back and relax and just try and take in the information. So the coding steps, the first thing we want to do is determine all the arteries and branches that were worked on. So I recommend have a worksheet, list them out. What did you do? So it might be the left main had an atherectomy. The right coronary had a stent and an atherectomy. So if you can list out what was done to each vessel, each branch, that will make it much easier for you visually to be able to code it. Now, the second step is for each recognized artery or branch, and this is the list here that we just looked at, list all the procedures next to it that were done. Now, we want to figure out which one had the highest intensity level service done, because we want to code them in order of highest level intensity to lowest. And this chart here, let me make it a little bigger now, is taken right from the guidelines. The guidelines tell you for the base codes, this is the hierarchy order. So a 92943 is the most intense procedure. If you did a revascularization for a chronic total occlusion, that's the highest level procedure you could do. Okay? The next in the hierarchy is 92941. That's also revascularization, but it's for an acute or subtotal occlusion. And this one, very key, it's during an acute MI. So this is an emergent procedure that they go in and do. That there's a heart attack going on. And so that's this code. These include any of those procedures we just talked about, the angio, the atherectomy, or the stenting. You could do one, you could do all three. You don't code them in addition to. They're part and parcel of this code. Big combo code is what this is. 92933 is the next step down. This is when you're doing stents with an atherectomy and angioplasty if performed. So, and notice the stents are in plural. Sometimes they will do two stents in the same vessel. You still only report one unit of 92933 because it's stent or stents. Next on the hierarchy going down is 92924. This is just an atherectomy. There's no stent. If they also did the balloon angioplasty, the PTCA, that's bundled in. Have to do both. It's if performed. Next step down, 92937. This is another revascularization. I did all the revascularizations in red. And this one is of a coronary artery bypass graft. So that's key. If you're not working, if the documentation isn't showing that they were working on a graft, then this is not the code selection for you. It also includes any PCI. The next level down is a 92928. This is a stent with angioplasty, or just a stent. And then last but not least, 92920, angioplasty. That's the balloon angioplasty that we showed the picture of. So these are for the base codes. You want to figure out if you had, like, the right main had one of these, had a stent, then you have to figure out, was a stent with an atherectomy, or was it just a stent, or maybe with an angio. So that will tell you it's a 933 or a 928. Did they also have a revascularization done? Oh, okay, well then that's going to be a 937, unless they also had a heart attack going on. So you got to figure out all those variables and code the highest one, Okay. Now, on the right-hand side of this picture, these are for the add-on codes. For the most part, add-on codes are used when you have an additional branch being worked on. The base codes can be used for main arteries and branches, but when it's an additional branch, then you're going to use this add-on code. The only exception is this first one, 92944. It's for additional artery or branch, but everything else is for an additional branch. Okay, so this is the hierarchy that they give you in CPT. So for the most part, they match side by side with what we saw for the base codes. The one exception here is 92938 is considered the second highest in intensity, the revascularization, which is an add-on code to this one here. So don't think they always go hand in hand like that. Then the third one down is 92934. That's the stents with the atherectomy. The next one down, 92925, is just the atherectomy with possibly an angioplasty. And then we're back to the stents only or with an angioplasty, and finally just an angioplasty. Okay? So now you have this pecking order figured out. Now you need to take a scenario and try and put it together. Oh, before I do that, I wanted to show you what my CPT manual looks like of what I just showed you, because on the board exam, unless you wanted to write all that down that I just gave you, you probably don't want to do that. So mark up your manual to have these little helper points here. So let's. All right, so scenario builder. I had made this little game that I wanted to try with you guys, and basically I'll show you real quick. Just so you could practice with yourself on all the different scenarios, I put in all of the vessels, right? And so we're going to click to spin. Let's see if we can code it. I don't know if you can hear that.
We can.
My kids were very excited when I was doing this. They came running in the room. They're like, what is that? I said, homework. Then they ran away. So, all right, so this is telling me the marginal, one of the marginals off the LC branch. So let me just write that down. So what did I say? Marginal off LC branch. Okay, so that's our vessel. So now let's figure out a procedure that's done to that vessel. Who wants to give me a procedure? Let's do stent with atherectomy. All right, and so let's also do another vessel. Let's do the RC, which is a main vessel. And let's do a revascularization. And they have a subtotal occlusion. All right, so now we got this. Using our little chart. Which code is going to have the higher level of intensity? Is it going to be the stent with the atherectomy or the revascularization? I should have done a poll. Okay, yeah, so it is the revascularization. And we have two revascularization codes. We've got one that's chronic total occlusion and one that's subtotal. And I said it was subtotal, so our code is going to be 92941 for that most intense procedure. So now we want to code this marginal branch that's off of the LC. That could be done. Probably not always. So how would we code that one with a stent and an atherectomy? So the first question we have to figure out, should we be in the base code column or should we be in the branch column, the additional branch column? What do you say? Base or add-on codes? Come on, what do you think? Put it in the chat. Base. Very good, Delissa. So yes, it would be a base code because it's not an additional branch off of the main, the RC main. So it would get its own base code. So this one, stent plus atherectomy, here it is. That's going to be the 92933. Okay? Now, if we change this to be the same scenario, but now we're going to make it, let's make this off the RC branch. So it's branch off the RC vessel, I meant. So now this is an add-on code. I could spell right. So how would we code a stent in an atherectomy? That's an add-on code. It's going to be this code here, 92934. So 92941 plus 92934, which is an add-on code. Okay, so hopefully that helped you with understanding the PCI codes better. I had fun doing it, and you know, there's some more examples if you're a Replay Club member to kind of keep, you know, testing that out. But this chart should help a lot, and I think we're going to probably be making that available on the site as a freebie, because I know this is a real tricky area.